Johans, to Mira for directing it, for Thorsten for pulling up, Thorsten I should say, sorry, for putting together his film, but to everybody, the performers. It's been great, thank you. Thank you very much. Inspired me to write Wreckage of Dreams, because to me that's the most important thing about it. It's an event that happened in 2011 during the conflict in Libya. On the 26th of March 2011, a small boat left Tripoli heading for Lampedusa, an island which has tragically been in the news recently. On that boat were 72 people, 50 men, 20 women and 2 children. Their intended destination, as said, was Lampedusa. It should have been an 18-hour voyage, but before they could reach it, they ran out of fuel. In total, they drifted on the Mediterranean for 16 days. On the 10th of April, they washed back up on the Libyan shore. By that point, there were 11 people left alive. During the time that they were on the Mediterranean, adrift, they encountered several other vessels. The first was a helicopter. Survivors said that it was painted green with the words "Army" stenciled on the side. It hovered over them, it dropped food, biscuits and water. It indicated that it was back, but then it left and never returned. A few days later, they encountered a couple of fishing boats. They were properly adrift by now, no fuel left. But they drifted close enough to say to them, "We have no fuel. We're running low on food. We're running low on water." The fishermen pulled up their nets and left. I understand, reading about the recent tragedy in Lampedusa, that there are some fishermen who sail in those waters who are afraid to pick up what are termed irregular immigrants, because they're afraid they'll be prosecuted for. I see that recent events are possibly bringing a change in the law, which gladdens me, but I'm just sorry that it took a tragedy to bring it back. But, back to the raft. A few days after the encounter with the fishermen, they encountered an aircraft cabin. They drifted close enough that they could see people on the deck, watching them with binoculars and taking photos. A couple of jets took off and flew over the raft so that they could survey, I guess. When the aircraft carrier began to sail away, the refugees thought they were being guided to safety. They thought they were being shown the correct way into Lampedusa. Some of them jumped overboard and tried to push the raft in the same direction, but they were soon left behind. A few days later, they washed up back on Libya. I believe I said that there were 11 people alive at this point. As they came ashore, one more person, a woman, also died. The remaining 10 were arrested, thrown in prison. Without any medical care, one more of them died on the first day. When I read about that story, it made me feel angry. The intervention in Libya was justified because it was supposed to save civilian lives, save people. The question that came to me was, if that was the point, then why weren't these people saved? They've been put in danger by the very war that was being fought to save civilian lives, and they weren't saved. That was the question that I wanted to ask. It's not something that I think I can answer, because I don't think I would really like the answer at all. But I feel that's the most important thing behind it. And that's why I wanted to tell that story again tonight. But thank you all very much for listening.
Bravo!